Yo, what's up guys, it's T-Bag, and by popular demand, I decided to do another worst to best video. We've done a couple in the past about every sidearm in Battlefield 1, about every gadget, every shotgun, and even every elite class. Loads of people asked me to do another one on sniper rifles and LMGs. Well, I will make that video, don't you worry about that, but today I decided to do another one on behemoths in Battlefield 1. Obviously, we only have a few behemoths to go through, so it's gonna be a short video, but it's gonna be entertaining nevertheless. So without further ado, let's start off with the worst behemoth in Battlefield 1, in my opinion. I always feel the urge to say that because a lot of people still get triggered by lists like these. So anyway, the worst behemoth in Battlefield 1 is definitely the Dreadnought, and let me explain why. A behemoth is there in order to give a helping hand to the losing team. The behemoth provides some insane firepower as well as extreme armor and an easy possibility to capture some flags. Well, sadly, that's not really the case with the Dreadnought. Although I do think it has the highest amount of health out of all the behemoths, it doesn't do much else compared to the other behemoths. For example, it only has 4 seats, 2 anti-air cannons and 2 artillery cannons. Although the artillery cannons are probably the most powerful in the game, the anti-air cannons have very little effect. See, there are only a few maps in the game where the Dreadnought can spawn as a behemoth. And on those maps, airplanes tend to stay close to the objective, so the AA cannons see very little action on most maps, maybe except for Heligant Bite. Another problem with the Dreadnought is that because it's only restricted to the ocean, it cannot capture any flags, which is kind of the main point of a behemoth, to help the losing team win. And yes, as you can see, I am Modest Pelican. You guys finally know who I truly am. Anyway, on to the next behemoth on the list, the Armored Train. In my opinion, this is basically a more agile version of the Dreadnought. See, the Armored Train does have the capability to capture some flags depending on the map you're playing. For example, out the top of my head, the train can capture 3 different flags on Sinai Desert, although its mobility is still limited by the fact that it's, well, on rails, it's a train. That being said, it also has an array of powerful weaponry. Like the Dreadnought, it has 2 seats for a mortar cannon, which functions similar to the artillery bow rush of the Dreadnought, but slightly less powerful. It also has some regular heavy machine guns, which are great to take out enemy infantry in your direct line of sight. It also has, like the Dreadnought, some AA cannons, which are actually very useful this time because of the maps where the armored train spawns. Except for maps like MEA, for example. But again, on Sinai Desert, it's very useful. And finally, it also has an auto turret at the back with some explosive rounds. Again, very useful against infantry, and it also does damage to vehicles. But the armored train has nothing on the airship behemoth. There are a few factors to why I think the airship is better than the armored train. First of all, it's not on rails, and it can go anywhere it wants. You can go to the outskirts of the map if you want, and you can go to any flag if you want. So that alone is a big plus. Another reason why I think it's so good compared to the armored train is the fact that you have the advantage of the sky. You are up above, which is a huge pro if you're fighting the enemies on the ground. What I mean by that is, you can actually hide from the armored train, but hiding from the airship is a lot harder, especially since there are like 5 gunners constantly looking down on you with auto turrets which fires explosive rounds. Another huge plus is that on game modes like Operations, your team can actually spawn on top of the airship and parachute down to the objective. So you basically have a mobile spawn point on the objective if your airship is hovering above it. And don't get me started on the weapons. The driver seats can drop bombs which are extremely powerful. The other, I believe, 5 gunners can cause absolute mayhem down below. And to defend against airplanes, it also has 2 machine gunners on top of the airship. The downfall of the airship though, and my reason for it not to be on number 1, is the fact that it's constantly exposed. You'll notice that from the second the airship spawns in until it gets destroyed, it's getting shot at from every single direction. So in essence, it's basically a behemoth on a timer. Also, all the occupants except for the driver can be shot and killed whilst being in the airship. For those reasons, I give the number 1 spot to the Char2C tank. Sadly, this behemoth, which I rate the best, is the least played out of all of them. And that is because it's only playable on 2 of the 4 maps from the French DLC They Shall Not Pass. Which is a shame in my opinion. It would be a very cool addition if they added this behemoth to some of the vanilla maps, like for example St. Quentin's Scar. Anyway, why do I think that the Char2C tank is the best behemoth out of all of them? Well, firstly, it's not on rails, so it can go anywhere on the map. Second, unlike the airship, all the occupants are safe on the inside. And thirdly, the driver's main cannon is the most powerful cannon in all of Battlefield 1, at least I think. This thing is absolutely insane. It can two-shot any tank in the game, and it can even one-shot light tanks. It's absolutely crazy. Sadly, I don't have much gameplay of it, since, like I said, it's kind of rare to drive one of these bad boys. Anyway guys, that's about it for the video. Do you agree with this list, or would you change it up a little bit? Let me know down in the comment section below. Like the video if you enjoyed it, and if you want to see more like these, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Oh, and don't forget to turn on notifications so YouTube won't screw me over. That being said, thank you for watching, and I see you guys next time.